It's interesting to see that even before I start my argument, already people are discussing in the room. I don't know whether it's about this statement or not. Anyway, I prepared 2 pages, but I'm not going to use them. Let's go back to the movie that we saw, because we didn't discuss the movie yet, to illustrate this argument here. It was a nice movie, well made, but it was overly simplistic, I think. And it's illustrated by questions like, are you pro or against GM? The question that we asked in this room, are you pro or against GM? And then you have to say yes or no. Now, even on Facebook, if they ask you your status, you can say it's complicated. But here you can't. There's no room for debate. There's no room for a more balanced position. It's yes and no. And I know what I'm speaking of. I've been put in the pro side and I've been put in the against side. And I don't know after this evening what is going to happen. Now, I think that basically, it's because of this kind of questions that you cannot have a real debate. And of course, I understand that you are confronting this Jeffrey Smith with scientists. It's attractive, it's sexy, it creates dynamic, and it's again provocative in a way. That's how I read this. Now, I think that proponents and opponents actually very often in public debates, not when you talk to them in private, but in public debates, they make the same mistake. They consider technology, GM technology, as something out there. And then you have the people who say that, oh, it's just technology out there. And we as human beings, we can dictate what the technology has to do. And you have the other ones who say it's just technology out there, but it's going to overrule human beings. The Frankenstein food idea. Now, both are overly simplistic as well, as if technology is just out there. Now, the research that we have done in Flanders, but also on a European level, was actually using, I'm not going to explain the theory, but it's called its mediation theory. And it takes as a starting point that human beings and technology, they interact. They mutually influence each other. A technology will make people behave in a particular way, but the technology is also designed because people put some ideas in the technology. Now, this is not a yes or no question. That's a complicated matter. And I think if you want to proceed in the discussion, if you want to have a kind of optimistic future, how to get rid of this lock-in situation in Europe, then we will have to get rid of this yes or no debate. Now, I think that what I said, the GM debate is not the GM debate. What I want to say is that I think that GM as a technology, but also as a political matter, also as a whole set of practices, is being used in Europe, I'm referring to Europe, I don't know the other context, is being used to ask other questions. When we started the discussion here, we just started for 5 minutes, and we were talking about colonization, about Leopold II, for God's sake. So, and that happens time and again. You have it should be a debate on a technology, but it happens to be a debate on other issues. And that's why I think in Europe for the past 3 decades, we have that debate. Because it's being used to ask fundamental questions about agricultural systems, about society, about the relation between human beings and technology, and so on and so forth. And it could have been, and that's a very puzzling question for me, why did this happen with GM and not with other technologies? That's a very puzzling question. I have no answer on that. I have no answer. But I think that it was just, to some extent, a matter of coincidences. That technology was there at that particular time, at that particular era in Europe, and therefore, GM became a catalyst to question, to ask fundamental questions about where we are going with our society, with our food system, and so on.
Why is this technology treated differently than other technologies in political debate, human debate, and so forth? I think because we're changing the fundamentals of life, it's DNA, and if you change that, people get afraid. Where does it stop? I think that's very fundamental, the fear, or the people of changing the DNA, the fundamentals of life. I think that is very important. Why it's changed, why it's treated differently, I think, also comparing to other technologies.
I just wanted to add that I think because we have debates on do we want GM in Europe, yes or no, we are not able to ask the question, could we allow a particular GM in a particular context? And that would be a kind of a question which is politically difficult, but that would be a kind of question that would allow people who are now opponents to discuss together about their future. Now, I think that what we need in terms of research is not necessarily more research on the technological side of it. I think we need research on skills, on methodologies, on procedures of that allow politicians to deal with that kind of questions. And I think, of course, I'm pleading for my own discipline, but we need research that provides us the skills of having and steering a complicated debate. We don't have the skills. And even talking with politicians on a Flemish, on the level of the Flemish Parliament, they say that as well. To use a big buzzword, we call it sometimes discursive representation. How can you allow different discourses to be represented in the empowered space where decisions are being made? And they say we would like to do that, but we just do not know, we don't have the skills to do that in the procedures and in the knowledge that we have. Thank you very much. I will have to go.
Thank you very much.